all the time to be alive. Today we'll check the latest Photoshop AI update that can do this with a couple of clicks. Let me show you the whole process. I opened the visualization of the house in the forest from our 3ds Max Advanced Exterior Visualization course. Link to the training in the corner if you are interested. Anyway, let's imagine that we need to create a 16:9 ratio from this vertical image. It's a complicated image with lots of details, so I'm pretty excited about what we will get. I'm sure you are too. To make the magic happen, we need to turn on the Contextual Task Bar window. And here it is. We can select the subject and remove the background, but I don't think it's really useful for visualizations at the moment. It seems to work well with figures though. To use the Generative Fill, we need to have something selected. Let's use a rectangle selection. Now, you can see that we get few new options in the panel. Let's click Generative Fill. We can either leave it empty and it will create something based on the surroundings, or we can type exactly what we want, which I definitely prefer. And now, click Generate. Here we go. I don't feel this works great. It's not a problem though, as we can see more variations. I don't like any of this too much. We can generate again and see what we'll get. This one doesn't work at all. Let's see another one. This is quite nice. Let's see the last one first. I definitely like this one the most. Let's leave it. It's not perfect, of course. The reflections don't look similar, but it's good enough for now. Imagine how much time we will spend to get this level of detail in the 3D software. Let's work on the top left corner. Let's type forest, trees with sunny leaves. Wow, nice! Let's see other variations. Okay, here we can see some issues. And this one doesn't work well either. But I like the outcome of the first one. Now, we can try to select a larger area and see what we'll get. Let's say forest, planting, sunny. Okay, not too great. I don't like this one either. This doesn't work as well. We can generate more variations. The results are off. We could use, for example, the foreground from this one and generate something else from the background, but I will try to generate smaller pieces from scratch. We can type the same words as before. I quite like this shrub here. Here there are some weird issues. This doesn't work too. I leave this one and generate a better looking area here. Let's try mossy stones, wild grass. Cool, we've got quite nice options. I like this one, it groups image nicely. We could of course adjust the colors to make it much better. Anyway, I would try to generate something nice at the top. Oh, these results are pretty weird. We got some odd elements. Plus, they definitely don't match the style. Let's try again. If we are not happy with the results, we can try to generate variations a couple of times. I think this may work, but I will add something else in the foreground. Let's type sunny leaves in the foreground. This one works quite well. The tree curbs the image. By the way, we can also change the variations from here. Now, we can see our before and after. It's obviously not perfect yet, and it may create some weird results, but for the time we put here, plus taking into consideration it's a better version, we need to agree that the results are impressive. What is cool, we can also work on smaller pieces of the image and have more control over the results. I would definitely add a mossy stone here, as it will add a nice transition between rocks and grass. Cool, just the colors are off. We can easily adjust it. Let's add the hue saturation adjustment. Now I desaturate greens. And definitely yellows as well. Here we go. Now it matches the colors way better. I feel it will be nice to add something to the river, as this large reflective surface catches too much attention. Not a problem. By typing mossy branch, we can easily fill up this area. I would say that we don't use this tool as extensively as in the previous examples, but it can be really useful for quick adjustments like this one, to fill up areas that are not designed or specified in the project. I would also try adding people with this tool, as this may be really helpful. I type something more specific. A girl crouching and collecting pebbles from the river. Nice! There are issues with the hands, but it's a cool result. This girl is great. Still, there are issues with the hands, but we could fix this. So basically, if you feel that a specific area needs to be fixed or needs more detail, you don't have time to do it in 3D, and using AI seems to be the better option. This generative fill in Photoshop can be a great choice. With just a couple of clicks, we can generate various options. I cannot wait to see an improved version of this tool in the future. If you want to learn how to create advanced exterior visualizations with a lot of details in 3ds Max, visit our website. Also, if you are into AI, you may be interested in these videos. Bye-bye!